Hey everyone, welcome back to the Scriptcase Macros course. This video is going to look at the SC menu disable macro. So my name is Nate Carpenter, and I'm the Scriptcase instructor leading this course. So let's go ahead and get started and look at what this macro does. You might have seen the SC menu delete macro. This is very similar, except it disables a menu item instead of deletes a menu item. So let's go ahead and look at the documentation for this. So as you can see, very simple. You just pass through the ID of the item, and it's going to disable this, and it's going to disable any child nodes or child items of that menu item as well. So let's go ahead and copy this and take it over to our Scriptcase menu in our development environment. So as you can see, I have two items on this menu. Item 2 is going to be the item that we're going to remove here. There's that ID. Let's go ahead and run this so you can see this. So we've got our main actor one and then actor grid here, and I click that and it loads our grid of actor. So let's go back here and disable that. So we need to go to events and then the onload event. And then go ahead and copy in that macro. And now we need that ID for that item. So if we go back to menu items, we can find that ID. I showed it to you earlier. Let's go ahead and make sure we get the correct one. So I go back here and I click on that actor grid item, and item underscore 2 is the name of that. Let's go back to our onload code and copy that in there, make sure I put the semicolon there, and go ahead and run this, and it should disable that item. So it'll be there, but we can't click it. So wait for the form to load here. It's going to come around here. There we go. There's our form loaded. And as I mouse over the actors section here, you can see it's grayed out. I can't click that option at all. So that's how you use the SC menu disable macro to disable an item on the Scriptcase menu.